Hello, I'm LaDonna Boyd, bringing you the lesson for May 3rd, 2020. The title of our lesson is The Return of Joy, and it comes from Zephaniah chapter 3. Today I'm reading from the College and Career Young Adult Christian Education resource from R.H. Boyd. Even through today's trials and tribulations, it is still important to find joy in the simple things of life. God's joy is all around us, and it is our job to seek it. What can take your joy? Is it possible for joy to be stolen? Today's lesson comes from the book of Zephaniah chapter 3, and Zephaniah was a prophet of Judah who served during the reign of King Josiah. His name means the Lord hides. This name is significant because it refers to God's protection of his faithful remnant during the time of judgment, or perhaps it refers to God's protection of Zephaniah at the time of his birth during the reign of an evil king. The people of Judah had abandoned God and they needed to be purged from their sins. God gave them the opportunity to repent and sent his prophet, Zephaniah. The judgment of God is not something that one can choose not to be affected by or hide from. It expresses the sovereignty of God over his creation. Sin does not go unpunished, but God is just and merciful. In Zephaniah 3, verses 14 through 16, it says, "Sing aloud, O daughter Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you, and he has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall fear disaster no more. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, 'Do not fear, O Zion. Do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness, and he will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing.'" The beginning of the passage is a song of celebration for the forgiveness and vindication of God. This provides a message of future hope and joy. What causes joy in your relationship with God? As joy returns to the people of God, it is cause for reflection. Our interaction with God can create feelings of joy or sorrow, and much of what we receive is left up to our own interpretation. Even so, it points to the words in Psalm chapter 30, verse 5. "Weeping may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning." God refreshes us and brings joy to his people. At times of judgment and hardship, the words of Zephaniah are comforting. God will never leave his children. It may be a struggle for some to find him, but he is ever present and there is joy in his kingdom. In closing, I encourage you to find the joys of today and say a prayer of thanksgiving to God for deliverance through this time. Again, I'm LaDonna Boyd, and I hope that you've enjoyed this lesson. Please share your thoughts with us on our website at www.rhboyd.com or our social media channels at rhboydco.